is going on, guys? It's Wafir. Welcome back to some more Jurassic World. Last time we left off, we actually opened up the T-Rex enclosure. Let's go look at those over here. And we actually laid down six more T-Rex eggs, and all six of those became male T-Rexes. So now we have three really old female T-Rexes, and then we have three or six very young male T-Rexes. So I don't know what's going to go on there. Anyways, we tried to name our Dilophosaurus, and then it, you know, attacked us. It went all rogue on us and tried to murder us. And I got some comments saying they was trying to murder a Brownie, and I was just kind of in the way, and I just kind of got hit and murdered, you know. So I don't know about that, because I did walk up to him. And he did straight up murder me once I, and there's my dead body right there, my skeleton. And since then, I actually came over here and built the little outline of what I want to have for the other side of our carnivore pens over here. I don't know what we're going to put over here. Maybe more Dilophosaurus, more Herrerasaurus, more Carnotaurus and stuff like that. Who knows? But this is all I've gotten done. I've gotten like the outline and then this first cage almost done. So I also have to do a ton of terraforming over here just so it kind of blends in and it doesn't have, you know, it's not just floating here. It doesn't even have a ground, and there's even a pool of water down here. So I need to fix that up here pretty quickly. Also, I went ahead and built Brownie's stable, like finished the rest of Brownie's stable, and I think it looks pretty good. It's a part of our house now, and you know, it kind of shares the same roof. Like the roof is like attached to the garage of Brownie's stable, and you can see it right now. It looks kind of good. I like that. Yeah, you can see it. It looks fantastic. Over here, I have instead of putting like windows or whatever over here, I put fences, so it looks a little bit more outside-y, you know. And look at that, Brownie's totally happy. Brownie loves his little stable. And then back here, you know, it connects through that little doorway. Let's go inside of it actually real quick. Let's take a look at it from the inside. So here we go. It's three wide. You only need it to be two wide for a horse, but I made it three wide to make it a little bit more opened up here for Brownie. And I still have this reinforced iron fence gate that's in the way that I guess I'm never going to get rid of, because I can never break it. I don't know what you need to break that, but I can't break it apparently. So there you go. Anyways, here's Brownie sling, and there's a little like sunlight beam thing opened up on the roof, so you know, natural light can come down from the top and light this up nicely. And you know, the ground is still grass, you know, because he's a horse. I don't want him to have wood floors like me, because I'm, you know, a human. I'm not a horse. He wants to eat some of that grass, eat some of that wheat. He can. So there you go. And I think that might be. Oh yeah, I also went over to the smeltery, and I got some comments saying that I should hook up some hoppers to this thing, so it's a lot easier to retrieve all the blocks of iron and stuff like that. So I actually did that. I have hoppers underneath each and every one of these basins, so if I pour iron down into these basins and let them pour real quick, let's see how much iron. Ooh, we still have a ton of iron. Gee. And wait, what happened to this? Oh, okay. It's automatically retrieving the iron blocks through the hoppers, and there you go. All the iron blocks are harvested, and they all go to this one single chest right here, and we have an absolute ton, two stacks of iron blocks, almost two and a half stacks. Jeez. In the future, I guess I could try and hook them up to the actual the searing tables or casting tables over here, and that way we can get ingots and, you know, different weapon parts and stuff like that that we'll need for like maybe a cleaver or something that we do want to make. Now, speaking of a cleaver, I did mention a few episodes ago that I want to go to the Nether, get some cobalt, maybe some ardite, maybe make some mandolin. And what we need to do is actually get ourselves some obsidian, so we can actually make the Nether portal, of course. So I thought, you know what, might as well make ourselves an obsidian generator, and those things are pretty cheap. All you need is one bucket of lava, and I don't really want to go to a meteor and mine that up myself. So what I'm going to do is get... Do I have any... Oh, there you go. You're going to find all the buckets, so there you go. I think I have an extra lava over there. Yeah, it looks like, judging by the menu, it looks like we have some lava over there, so we'll have to worry about that. And let's see, what kind of building blocks? I guess I'll get these stone bricks. Yeah, I think that should be pretty good. And yeah, that seems pretty good. All right, so what we need to do is just make this out of stone bricks and get rid of that lead. We don't really need that lead in our inventory right now. There we go. And what we need to do, I guess I can keep it in my inventory. What we need to do is get some of those cobblestone. Do we have any wood? Ah, man, we have a little bit of wood. Ooh, we should probably cut down a few more trees. But we also need redstone and iron. Do we have any of that? Yeah, we have a little bit of redstone, and we have, of course, a million blocks of iron. No problem. So let's go cut down some trees real quick. Just a couple. We don't need to cut down too much. And I guess we can make it over here. We want to make ourselves some pistons, and we only need like two, I think, yeah, two pistons. I think that should be it, right? And there you go. Got a little bit of wood right there. I think that one dropped an apple, right? Yeah, it dropped an apple too. Nice. Let's see. Let's get some wood from this tree over here. This isn't even a tree. It's like a bush or something. It is a rather tall tree, though. There we go. Oh, it's only two blocks. Whatever. All right. This should be way more than enough. There we go. And we do have a crafting station over there by our smeltery. So let's go build it over there. And yeah, by the location. Yeah, we should probably put this obsidian generator over there by the smeltery. Yeah. That's a pretty good spot. All right. So let's see. Let's make ourselves some pistons. So let's make this auto-craft it for us. There we go. Piston. And oh, I need to turn all these into iron ingots. There we go. And turn those into pistons. Really? Oh, wait. I need to break these down into planks. So there we go. And now it should auto. There we go. So we only need, I think, two. Yeah, I think you only need two pistons, and yeah, that should be good. Let's get a third one just in case we need it. So there we go. Ooh, I think we need gelatinous slime. Hopefully some of these slimes spawn from this thing. Anyways, we need to fill up one bucket with, actually, yeah, we need more than one bucket. Meh, I'll just fill up one bucket for now. And let's go build the actual, like, general enclosure of this thing. I don't know how big it's going to be. I've never built it decently big. I guess I can cut down this tree. Meh, I don't really need it. Got the dumb plant in the way. Get out of your plants. I should probably build it, like, right here-ish. Yeah. All right, so I guess I could just build it like this. Maybe terraform it around the obsidian generator itself. So let's see. So if I'm going to have the lava block right here, I need to come out like so. I think lava spreads by five blocks, right? Three or five blocks, one of those two. I know it's an odd number, so if I have a lava block there, it's going to fall like so, and this is going to be our obsidian generator, a general shape. So if we put this like this, then we need to put water in on the inside. This is going to look really weird at first, but it's going to take shape hopefully very soon. Hopefully I don't need to move this. Yeah, I think this is a pretty good size. I think it's a pretty good size. All right, so what I need to do now, let's put some obsidian or some lava up here, about right here. And then here is going to be the front. So it's going to be about like this. There we go. And this is taking, this is, oh man, this is so, this looks like a big pile of blocks right now to most of you, I bet, if you've never built an obsidian generator. So it's going to be about like this, right? That's the center of it. And that's where the lava is going to go. I don't know. Anyways, I think I'm going to continue this on my own, and I will see you guys here in a bit. Alright, so the original design I went for was a little bit ambitious. I'm not going to chug around here. That was a little bit too much. I didn't really need it to be that big, so I simplified it down to like a one block obsidian generator, and all we need to do now is get one piece of redstone, place that here, and then hit this lever, and hopefully, oh wait, nope, there's a block that goes here. There we go. I need to get that one out of the way. Ooh, wait. I don't think I tested this correctly. Let's put one a little bit more iron bars about here-ish. There we go. All right. And then we put that like so. And then hopefully we will be able to break this properly and get ourselves some obsidian. So let's see. Is that going to get us an obsidian block? Hey, it worked. All right. Let's close that up. Let's get that piece of obsidian. And that should be easy peasy, no problem. All right. So there are better designs out here that I could have made, but you know what? This one gets the job done quite nicely. And I think maybe I can hook this thing up to like some hoppers and stuff, so I don't need to worry about coming over here and grabbing the obsidian. Who knows? I don't know. But right now, all you need to do is just flick that lever real quick and then come down here. Oh, wait. Oh, no. I'm going to die. Oh, man, I forgot to put the redstone down. The redstone is probably the most important part, because without the redstone, it's not going to turn into obsidian. So we need to get ourselves one piece of redstone, place it down there. And the original build I was going to do called for, you know, having four pieces of redstone or so, and it can make four pieces of block or four pieces of obsidian at a time. But that one was a little bit too big, so I went for this one singular obsidian block generator thing, and I think because we're in 1.7, we can make a really small nether portal. I don't know. I think, oh no, I forgot the redstone again. Oh, we're gonna die. Oh man, God, I literally just talked about how we need redstone, and I just completely forgot it like it's nothing. Oh man, actually, you know what? I don't think there's any way of me like automating this outside of what I already have. So let's get that like that. and let's get ourselves some more obsidian. So I'm going to use this obsidian generator until we have enough obsidian to actually make ourselves another portal. So I'm going to keep on mining these, and I'll see you guys here in a bit. All right, there we go. We have 10 obsidian. Now we can make ourselves another portal. Now, this is a bit close to our smelter, I guess. On my own, I could cut down this tree on my own. I can move this back to 3 blocks about where that tall grass is there on the left. I guess I can move it back there, and that'll free up 3 blocks here. Yeah, that'd free up quite a bit of room, so I guess I'll do that on my own. Maybe even move it to, like, right here, actually. Yeah, this is a pretty good spot. Yeah, not bad at all. So, yeah, it is a bit closer to the smeltery right now, but I'll move that on my own. It is a pretty simple little design. If you guys don't know how it works, you just have a little piece of water in the back, and then a piece of lava at the top with a piston, and then, of course, you just place down the redstone and let the lava flow onto the redstone and have water next to it, and then, for some reason, that makes obsidian. I've been using obsidian generators for years. I don't know how it works, but it works, so there we go. Anyways, where should we actually put our nether portal now? I was thinking maybe in the lab, but that is a bit close. I don't want the nasty, disgusting nether portal noise to get annoying, you know, but maybe down here in the caves, you know, it is a little bit down, and we don't have to, you know, get too close to it when we're doing our regular work. Actually, there is a 3x3 thing, like, right here. Ooh, I'm hearing some dinosaurs up there, so, do we have any torches? We could get some torches if I just get some coal real quick. Ooh, yeah, there's a little bit of coal right there. Yeah, let's grab that coal and make a singular torch real quick. And there we go. Or 4 torches, whatever. Let's see. And then we can place this down here. Then I can get rid of this wall here. Get rid of that, get rid of that. And then I guess we can place it down like so. So let's place another portal here. Hopefully it's not too close. Oh, whoops. I need to get rid of that one. Hopefully it's not too close to the lab and to my general house area to where this portal just sitting around is going to be too loud, you know? I hope it's far away enough. So let's place it down like so. There we go. And we're going to need to do that in the roof. So there we go. And there we go. And we just need to make ourselves some flint and steel. And I think we're ready to go. And I can take that torch back. All right. Well, other than that, we need to prepare to actually go to the nether. So what do we want to do while we're down there? Of course, we need to get some quartz. We need to get some quartz so we can make that ME machine so we can, get ourselves a bunch of storage for our stuff. We don't have to worry about these chests anymore. And of course, once we do have some quartz, we can use that on our weapons, make them sharper, give them more damage output, stuff like that, you know? So what I want to do is actually go grab our digital miner real quick. Let's go check up on that thing. Let's see if it has any a pretty good amount of amber, pretty good amount of fossils, stuff like that. Let's go check up on that. And we can take that to the nether and take that little 2 million RF thing that's over there, that's sitting over there, I totally forgot about. We can take that program to mine some nether quartz, and that should be good. Ooh, 32 diamonds. Ooh, 21 amber. A stack and 19 fossils. Not bad. And this one's completely done, too. Yeah, 0 to mine. Nice. So, ooh, yeah, I guess we can just break all this real quick, get all my flux ducks back, get these windmill things back. Get our digital miner back, and I guess we could put up all this random garbage I don't need anymore. Put that up inside there, and yeah, that's, yeah, easy peasy, no problem. Get rid of all that saplings, who needs that garbage, and pistons and that stuff. All right, and then I need, of course, a digital miner. Is that it? Oh, there's the windmill right there. I just randomly picked up 2 windmills, just casually forgetting about 2 windmills. All right, so let's head back to the house, and let's go grab our crescent wrench, and let's go over there and grab our 2 million RF capacitor bank, and then we can go through the nether portal. So I'll see you guys here in a bit. All right, let's head. Oh no, we fell in the water. Are you kidding me? God, get out of the OMLG jumping skills over here with this brownie. All right, we've got the crescent hammer real quick. Let's grab our 2 million RF capacitor bank and that flux duct, flux duct, not fluid duct. And let's go over to home, I guess. Make ourselves some flint and steel, and then we can go light the nether portal now. I don't know if wind is in the nether or not. I guess I'll bring 1 windmill and see if wind is in the nether. If it is, then wow, that's pretty impressive. And we can actually get ourselves some power. But if not, then, you know, this 2 million RF should be able to mine quite a significant amount of quartz down there. So, let's see. What was I going to do? Oh yeah, flint and steel. Let's see, do we have... God, don't turn that chest around. Do we have any flint just sitting around? Yeah, we do. We have some flint and we have some steel in our inventory. So let's make ourselves a flint and steel. There you go. And of course, we need to put up our amber and our fossils. Don't want to lose that. And our diamonds, of course. And I guess the rest of our stuff like that. There you go. And I think that's pretty much it. So let's get ourselves the flint and steel. Oh, I need some baked potatoes. Let's get ourselves the flint and steel. And let's head downstairs as we munch on some delicious, nutritious baked potatoes. And let's go and light that nether portal. I don't know what to expect down there. I don't know if there's any mods that are, like, modifying the nether that's going to make it a really interesting adventure or what, but there we go. The nether portal has been lit. We have a few torches. Ooh, look at that ender chest hat. Look at that. Get out of here. What? Oh, look at that. I've got the ender chest hat. Nice. Nice. All right, so what we want to do is, since... Ooh, I don't have that many torches. Ooh. You know what? Let's just go anyways. Let's just go anyways. We can set a waypoint at our portal. And hopefully this one doesn't spawn above a giant lava lake. Hopefully it's on land. Come on, downloading terrain. Oh, we just spawned down. Oh, smoldering grass block. Ew. Oh my god, I'm on fire. I'm already on fire. Oh man. Why am I on fire? I can't. Oh, those are those bone things. I totally forgot about those bone things. Man, we're going to get a ton of bones from that. And this is lead. And man, it's really dark. I probably should have brought some torches. Let's turn our brightness all. Oh yeah, that's a lot better. Oh, turn our bright. Oh my. Oh, I totally. They have the beehives in this mod pack. You kidding me? No. Why do they have those? Oh, there's a tombstone right there. I'm trying to scope out, seeing if I see any like cobalt or anything. All right, now I think there might be either cobalt or titanium right there. There's like a blue color right there, so I don't know. I kind of want to explore that. And is that salt over there? I can't tell. Usually I get salt and regular quartz mixed up, and I'm trying to make sure there's no pigment around. And I don't think there are in this general area, but I do, according to the minimap, see bees in that beehive over there, so we need to watch out for those guys. Alright, so I guess we can just program our digital miner real quick to mine ourselves a pretty good amount of ores. Hopefully the pigmen don't know about us. And wait a second. I don't know, let's type it in. Let's go to config, let's go to new filter, ore dictionary. What about quartz? Ore? Is that gonna work? Nope, it's not gonna work. Quartz, is that gonna work? There we go. Alright, let's save that, and let's move that up to the very, very top, and max, minimum, yeah. Let's just keep it at max, so if we have it like so. Oh, we're getting an absolute ton, and it's getting the actual ores and stuff too. I didn't know that. Oh yeah, because we do need to throw it into the furnace and actually get the quartz, I guess. So there you go. Is this getting power from the thing right here? I guess not. Do I have any? I did bring these flux ducts though, so there we go. Let's do a little bit of that. And is that getting power? I don't think it is. I don't know what's going on here. Is this even working? Let's see. Is this even? It's got one quartz ore. Stop. Start. This is rather interesting. It worked. It got one quartz ore right there. This is apparently not using any power. 2.6 is KRF. Is this stuck? Let's see. Type in the chat. Obama. Yeah, doesn't seem bad. Seems pretty fast. Well, you know what? Let's break this. Let's break that with the crescent hammer. And let's place it back down. Let's place it back down about right there-ish. Yeah, about like that. And then it's not even getting charged. Why is it not getting charged by this? Really? I don't know why it's not getting charged by this. That's really interesting. Auto-eject, pull, silk. It doesn't need auto-pull because I'm not pulling anything into it. Yeah, I don't know why it's not working. Yeah, that's really interesting. I guess we could put it back in our inventory real quick. Crescent hammer. Get all that stuff back. Oh, that was so close to getting burnt up there. And I guess we're just going to have to do it the dangerous way. Trying to get ourselves some quartz by, you know, mining it manually. So, let's see. Ooh, there are a few pigmen here, and oh my god, there's a phantom right there trying to murder me. Get out of your face. Oh, no, it's trying to murder me. Oh, how much health? Oh, I got it. Oh, man, I got it. Man, when did I get up to 64 levels? Where does that come from? What? I don't even remember. I died, like, not too long ago. Okay, well, there are pigmen here. We could kill them, but there's like a dozen of them in that direction. You know what? Should we try and do it? Let's do it. Let's try and murder him. Let's do it. Oh, we got that pigman. Oh, the other pigman see it? I don't know. Oh, that one knows. Oh, and there's a ghast shooting at me. There's a ghast. Oh, no. Oh, there's a really ghast. Really? Ooh. Ooh, there's like a nether jungle over there. What is that? I've never seen that. Well, either way, we have some quartz here. I guess we can mine them now. Let's grab that. There we go. Ooh, can this hammer not really? Oh, I guess it can, but I guess it doesn't break it quite as easily. Oh no, it's going to explode. It's going to explode. Oh no, it exploded. Oh no, what? Did it get out of here? What is it? Hellfish? Oh no, it's the hellfish. Oh, they're going to be a village in the Nether, maybe? Oh no, we're dead. This is it. I'm dead. Wow, and now I'm Steve again. John, we need to go back down there. What? Why am I 32 levels now? I just died. I don't know, huh? Well, that's really interesting. All right, a pigman made it through the thing. Oh my God, there's like three of them down here. Why are there? There's four of them down here. What? Dumb pigman, stop going through the Nether portal. God, I'm going to need to like fence that area in. Make sure you guys don't go in there. Oh no, we're on fire again. We're going to need to fix that up. Oh no, there's a baby pigman. Get out of here, baby pigman. Oh, God, I'm instantly dead. Instantly dead. I didn't even do anything. Gee. God. Okay, well, I'm going to need to try and get my stuff back. Actually, you know what? Let's go up there. Let's go make ourselves some emergency armor and weapons. Because we have a million diamonds, pretty much. So we might as well make ourselves an emergency set of armor, emergency diamond sword. So let's do this. Let's grab ourselves some sticks. Yeah, there we go. All right. Let's see. Diamond sword. There we go. Easy peasy, no problem. Diamond chest plate, diamond pants, diamond hat, and diamond shoes, no problem. Full set of diamond armor, doesn't even care. And let's just equip all that real quick. Look at that, now I'm level 16. I don't know why I'm losing half my levels. And it must have either glitched or I was a really high level when I died from Dilophosaurus or what? I don't know. All right, well, let's go back and get our stuff. Let's go back. Let's see. Oh, I'm on fire. I'm going to be out. Yep, I'm on fire again. Get away. Stop stepping on the smoldering grass. God. All right, baby pigman. Die already, baby. God, is there another hellfish down here trying to murder me? God, there's this ghast is still over here trying to murder me. Oh. God, that was so close. All right, there's two dead bodies here. There's the steel rape here. Let's grab our backpack. Come on, grab the cat. Can I just... Come on. Grab the backpack. Really? Can I not break that backpack? Can I not, Is that not gonna... Okay, whatever. Let's get it with the Paxil. Hopefully it breaks with the Paxil. Come on, backpack. Why is this backpack not breaking? What? Is that... That's like an indestructible backpack or something. Gee. All right, well, let's grab our knapsack. If anything, we can put our stuff from the backpack into the knapsack and open up a little bit more storage. So I guess we just put all this garbage up in there, put all this stuff back down here, and put that on one. And I guess we put the diamond sword on two. Yeah, there you go. Not bad. Get that back. Ooh, what is that? Silver nugget. Okay, whatever. And then we get rid of these dead bodies, like so. There you go. And that back. Oh, wait. Now it gives me the backpack? Really? Really? Oh, it must have been because I had the chest plate on. Okay. Let's take that off. Let's put the backpack. Really? I can't. Can I not put the backpack? Okay, there you go. And then I can put. Okay. All right. And let's just put all that garbage up inside there. All right. Random wind turbine as well. All right. So we have a little bit of quartz we can grab here. Hopefully. Oh, it's going to explode. Oh, let's get away. Oh, okay. Oh, it's spreading. The explosions are spreading. Oh, let's get out of there. Okay, man, that's still spreading, is it? Let's get ourselves baked potatoes. Oh, okay. We have a little bit of quartz. We have like 5 quartz right now, which is like nothing. I need to investigate why our digital miner isn't even mining the quartz for us. Ooh, no explosion. Okay, I must have grabbed the exploding or that was going to explode, but it never did. All right, we have some glowstone up here as well. Ooh, I don't know what we can use a glowstone for. But you know what? Let's just grab it. It's cheap, easy peasy, no problem. And, I don't remember there ever being anything inside of the bee's nest, wasp nest over here. But should we try and go inside of it and maybe see if there's anything special inside of there? Ooh, I don't know. Let's explore around here a little bit more. Ooh, there's some interesting stuff down here. I don't know if that's shiny or lead ore, right? No, I think that's like lead. All right. Flesh. There's these flesh blocks here. Come on, what is this? What is a chunk of flesh? Chunk of flesh. I don't even know what can you even do with this? You can make rotten flesh, of course. Why not? And then flesh blocks. So there you go. If anyone out there wants to make some flesh blocks, osmium ore right there. Then there you go. Just make some flesh blocks. Oh, ooh, mithril ore. Ooh. Can I mine? Oh, I can. Let's just grab a little bit of the, the pigman nose. Okay, where's that one singular pigman at? Come on, fight me, IRL pigman. Come on, fight me. Oh my god, that is one gigantic lava lake down there. Oh, man, let's go over here. Let's grab, what is this thing? Is this a sapphire? Yeah, it's a sapphire. I don't really need that. All right, yeah, nothing else over here that I'm seeing. And god, these little eyeballs, though. Let's grab some of those. Might as well, right? Nasty looking things. All right. Was that lead? Yeah, it's lead. And more flesh here. I guess I'll just dig through the flesh. Casually dig. Ew, little particles coming out of the flesh. Ugh. Let's see, is there anything else here? In this general area, at least? Another tombstone over there, some other stuff. I kind of want to go over there to that that area that I thought I saw the shiny and or cobalt ore. Let's see, do we have any nether? Nah, we have a little bit of netherrack on us. We can make it a little netherrack bridge over to that beehive and see if there's anything on the inside. But I don't think that there's anything inside of it worth noting. Ooh, another mithril ore. I guess we can grab that. Is there anything, like, interesting we can make out of this that is, other than, let's see. Blah, 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 yeah. I don't think I even want to use it. Whatever. Should I even continue grabbing it, though? I don't know. There's some quartz right there. And nothing else of interest. Pig iron. I don't know if we should get that, you know? There's ferrous there, though. I guess we can just dig through the wall real quick. Oh, quartz. Oh, it's gonna explode. Oh, let's just go. It's like, oh, man, we are caught in the explosion. That's it. We're dead. Ooh. Oh, man, we survived. Oh, it's still exploding back there. Gee. All right, there's our death down there. We need to... Oh, the big man knows. The big man know. Oh, man, we're dying super quickly here. Oh, okay, come on. Come on, pigman, get away. No. I'm on fire. I'm gonna die. Oh, one and a half hearts. Oh, I'm gonna pillar myself. I'm gonna pillar myself up. I don't even care. Oh, baked potato. Oh, man. Okay. Oh, man. Is that a, oh, man, I thought that was an Enderman right there. I was like, what? Why are you in the Nether, Enderman? All right, get out of your bit. Oh, look at the crazy eyes on him. Ooh, I kind of want that hat. Can I grab that? Ooh, googly eyes. Let's put that hat on. That's kind of interesting. Okay, we've had the T-Rex one for quite a while. Let's see. Googly eyes. Oh, man, we look absolutely, oh, we can't even see. Oh, it didn't even change for our hat. Ooh, I need to, let's see, where was it again? Googly eyes and done. Oh, look at that. Look at those eyes, especially with the little monocle that I had on. God, that's ridiculous. All right, get out of here, pigman. Get out. God, I should have made a bow. I really should have. Ooh, come on, get out of here, pigman. Oh, there you go. Oh, come on. Come on and murder. Oh, man, we got him. Huh, there's 10 right there. Okay, we have a little bit of nether. Oh, we actually had a pretty decent amount of netherrack. And we can pillar ourselves over or bridge ourselves over. Ooh, this is going to be dangerous. This is a one layer bridge. I can already hear the bees slash hornets slash whatever's inside of there. Okay, let's just try and see. Do a little safety measure here. I don't know if there's anything inside of here that's worth noting. I don't remember there ever being anything inside of here that's worth noting, but there are bees in here. God, there's one right there. There's one right there. Come on, get out. Oh no, I got stung. Oh no. Oh, come on, bees. Get out of here, bees. Get out. Bees, I just want to come in here and murder you. Oh, is that it? Oh, there's one there in the corner. Come on, bees. Come on. What are you thinking? Bees nuts. Bees. Come on, bees. Oh, is that it? Is that, oh, honeycomb block. Honey block. Ooh. Am I swimming in honey right now? I think I am. I think I'm just casually swimming in honey right now. Oh, man. This is crazy. Really? Okay, I'm hearing another bee. I don't know where he's at though. All right, some honeycomb blocks. I guess I'm gonna break these and grab them. I don't know, what do you use them for? Let's see. Honeycombs. Oh wait, empty honeycomb. You can make a honeycomb block, and ooh, you can use this cook stuff, but that's pretty garbage. Make a block cover facade, and you can use it. Yeah, you can use this cook stuff. Okay, that's garbage. What about the actual honey itself? You can make you. I guess there's no use for it then. What about the, what if I get a bucket? I have a little bit of water right here. And I know that in the Nether, water like steams up, so. Yeah, there you go. Let's grab this. Ooh, honey bucket. Can I eat that? Oh no, it's going to crash. Oh, got it crash. Oh man, the game crashed right there. Okay. Oh man, I just fell right back into the liquid honey. Okay, so I don't know what we're going to use this liquid honey for. Because apparently we can't eat it. We can't place it down. I guess it's just kind of funny. Ooh, what is that? Filled honeycomb. Ooh, what is that? What does that drop? Empty honeycomb. Okay, I don't know what it drops, but I'm about to drown. Literally drown in honey. Oh. Okay, let's just keep breaking these honey blocks for no reason. We use them for decoration, I guess. So I guess we can just break them like this and just collect them on the floor of the honey hive. So let's grab the... Ooh, what? Yeah, there's actually a pretty good amount of them down here. Ooh. All right, come on. Come on, break the rest of the honey. God, there's so much honey. There's so much honey all over the place. Let's just get out of here. Come on, let's just staircase our way literally out of the beehive right now. And hopefully there's not going to be a million bees outside trying to murder us. All right. Let's get out of here. Oh. Okay. I think that honey gave me like slowness or something whenever I came out of it. Oh, okay. There's a bee right there. He doesn't even know. He don't even know what I just did. He don't know I just ransacked his entire hive right there. It's completely empty. All right. Well, there's a bunch of bees out here. I don't know if any of them know. That one's looking right at me. That one, oh man, he knows. He's looking right at me. All right. These pigmen don't know that I just murdered some of their friends not too long ago. All right. God, can I get rid of this smoldering grass so I don't step in it and burn myself like I did last time? All right. There you go. Is this just going to drop regular grass or what? Man, I'll just put netherrack down. All right. And let's just go through the portal and let's go home. Hopefully there's not a billion pigmen back home. Jeez. Man, if anything, these pigmen are probably going to be making a bunch of noise down here compared to the actual nether portal itself. All right. So come on, download. Oh, there you go. God, another pigmen came through and a baby pigmen too. God, that's nasty. That's disgusting. Oh, man, I'm feeling that disgusting even frame rate lag now. Oh, God, that's disgusting. Down to 48 FPS. Oh, okay, we're up to 60 again. Ladies and gentlemen, we're back up to 60. No worries. All right. Okay, so... Wow, that was a pretty good little nether trip. So we have ourselves a decent amount of quartz. Do we have any more quartz? There's regular netherrack. Do we have any more quartz inside of here? Five. So we're up to 17. And then we need to go put that into what will give us the most quartz here. So let's see. That's going to give us one. Enrichment chamber is going to give us six. Ooh. We have an enrichment chamber. Oh, we're going to get a pretty good amount of quartz here. Ooh. And let's grab our rapier. And I guess we can upgrade that, give it more sharpness. And, see how high I can go. So we have there's six right there. I guess we're going to let the enrichment chamber do its thing. And let's see how much power does it get. Is it really getting... Yeah, it's actually getting a pretty decent amount of power from that one little lonely solar panel up there. Well, it's actually impressive. All right, so, wow, that was actually not that bad of a little nether trip. I thought it could have gone a million times worse. We could have fallen down into the nether lava and, murdered ourselves like that. So, ooh, we have the smithereal ore. I guess we could use that in the future. Here's a bucket of honey, then that's going to crash our game at a moment's notice if we really want to. And there's our glowstone blocks we can use for whatever we want, I guess. I guess we can place those glowstones out of there. Dirt, mithril, blah, blah, blah. Put all this garbage up inside of there. Meh, can't even fit anything inside of there anymore. French guy, got Gigan boots, get out of here. Let's check up on our quartz down here and try and sharpen our rapier. Now, we don't have cobalt, stuff like that yet, but I guess we might as well work with what we have. So let's see, is there any more steel inside of here? Ooh, we need to get some more coal if we want to get some more steel. So let's go down here. Let's try and find ourselves a little bit of coal. And yep, there's one coal right there. And then throw that into the pulverizer. So actually, I think we'll need more than just one. Let's get ourselves a couple, maybe like three. Let's break it with the iron hammer real quick. It's going to get us. Oh wow, look at that! That actually gave us a pretty decent amount. And there you go, up to 11. So, that is a pit of death. God, you can hear the T-Rexes upstairs just roaring our faces off. Man, there's pigmen downs. Excellent. Oh, on the minimap. Yeah, those are regular pigs I'm seeing on the minimap. Okay, that's not as bad as I thought. So, pulverizer. Let's get ourselves some pulverized coal. 30 more quartz. Not bad. All right, so we need one more. And there you go. All right, so now we can make ourselves that steel thing. So, let's see. If we get our... There it is right there. Right here. And do we have... I thought we had iron on us. Let's check. Iron... Didn't we have iron? Did we put it up? We might have. Well, either way, let's see. Is this... Yeah, steel is done. Let's repair our rapier. Where'd it go? It was just here a few seconds ago. But now it's gone. Really? What happened to it? It was just here. Am I completely blind right now? Is it like right in front of me and I don't see it? I'm pretty sure I put it inside the tool forge. What? Oh wow, I put it inside the tool station. Oh, wait a second. Yeah, why'd I put it there? That's weird. Alright, let's repair that up to full health and let's give it some quartz and stuff. So there you go, it's going to be... Let's see, what is the sharpness right now? It's, attack is 2 hearts. This one's up to 2 hearts right now. But that's only 3 quartz, so... Let's see, what do we need? We need 72 to go up to the next level to... What is it, sharpness 1 or what? So that should be pretty easy peasy, no problem, because we have 1 stack up there already. We have 26 more in our inventory, probably a pretty good amount more. Back at that enrichment chamber, up to 48 now, not bad. And let's just fill that up once more. And let's see, how much does this have? 60 out of 72. So only a little bit more, and 69 out of 72, and 72 out of 72, alright. And 3.5 now, okay, so it's at 3.5 hearts right now. The next one's at, you know what, I'll save my quartz for now. So it is at 3.5 hearts right now. It's about, what was that, 1.5 times better-ish? So that's not bad. So we have, 30 more quartz right there, so it would have been a waste anyways. Let's save that quartz. We could use that in case we get ourselves a cleaver, maybe like a cobalt cleaver or something here in the future. We can get ourselves a really, really sharp, good weapon. But, anyways, I think I'm going to end it right there. So thank you guys all very much for watching. If you guys enjoyed the video, be sure to let me know by leaving a like down below. And if you guys want more of these awesome videos, be sure to hit that subscribe button. I'll put my latest videos on YouTube homepage as soon as they come out so you don't miss an episode. But until then, thank you guys all for watching. And I will see you guys here next time, where we are probably going to do some more dino-related stuff. Now that we have our rapier like set up, and I'm going to look into the digital miner, why that wasn't working properly in the Nether. Maybe it doesn't work in the Nether like on the overworld? So I don't know for sure, but either way, thank you guys all for watching, and I will see you guys, God, I look so goofy, and I will see you guys here next time. Oh, bye there.